In this video, we'll show you how to create classes in WeWeb to reuse styles throughout your project. Let's start by creating three different styles of containers. We'll drag and drop a container element on our page. And for the purposes of this exercise, we want all our containers to have a padding of, let's say, 40 pixels and a background color of light blue. Let's say this is our default container and we want to create a class that we will call container. We'll create this class, and if we want to edit it, we can click on it, make sure that it's highlighted here. And in our style bar, we can see all the styles that are specific to this class container. So if I wanted to change the padding to 20, now this is grayish and no longer orange. So if I want to apply the 20 pixel padding to all the elements with the container class, I need to make sure that I save this change. And now that I've saved the change, padding is orange again. Okay, so I have this default container that looks like this. Now let's say I want different types of containers. I could have a subclass that we would call container large, for example. Create the subclass. And now that I make sure that I'm on container large, so I'm on the correct subclass, I can say that the max width in this case would be 1300 pixels. And again, you see that this is no longer orange, so I'm going to make sure that I save this change. Now, if I drag and drop a new container on the page, let's have it here. You see there's no style here because there's no class attached. So let's go and find the container class. Okay, so now it's our initial default container. And maybe this time we want to create a different subclass. Have it say container small. Create the subclass. Again, make sure we're on the right subclass before we style. And here the max width, we want it to be 450 pixels. It's grayish. Let's make sure we save our change. And if I change this to large, you see that because large is below small, it's overriding the style of small. If I dragged and dropped this above small, suddenly small is the last subclass, so it overrides the large setting. In this case, it doesn't make sense to have both subclasses on this specific container. So let's remove the large subclass here. Now we have one small container. Rename it here. If we want to, we don't have to. It has no influence on the style if we rename it, but it's just to help us see what we did here. So we have the small container with a container class and container small subclass. And then we have the large container with the container class and the container large subclass. Note that I cannot add a subclass. So I cannot add a container large, whatever subclass. So that's one very straightforward way to create a reusable style in WeWeb. Now let's have a look at another approach where we style buttons using different classes on the same button and using subclasses to save the state of a button. Let's say I wanted to create a bunch of different buttons with different styles like Bootstrap proposes here. So here in terms of code, what we have is for each button, we have two classes. The default BTN stands for button class, and then a different class for each button that kind of defines the style that we see here. So like the background color mostly, and the style of the background color on hover. So how would we do this in WeWeb? The first thing we'll want to do is create the BTN class. So let's add a button element on our page, drop it here, and maybe copy it several times. Now, let's call this one secondary, and this one primary. And on my primary button, I will create a class called BTN. Let's create this. And I said what I wanted to change was mostly the corner radius, so those rounded edges. And I can choose later to change something else. You see here, it's grayed out, and here it's orange. All the properties that are related to my class, my BTN class, should be orange, so I need to save this here to save the radius property to my BTN class. Now, if I go to my secondary button and apply the BTN class, it will have rounded edges as well. Let me just wrap this inside a container. And let's make this nice like this. All right, so I have these two buttons and they both have the BTN class. Now, what makes my primary button special? It has a specific background color and also on hover state, a different background color. So let's create a new class called BTN primary. And here, the only thing I want to change is the background color. So let's create this in my background color, and I make sure I'm on BTN, BTN primary. My background color should be primary. Now we'll do the same on secondary. I will create a new BTN secondary class, and I only want to change the background color. In here, it will be secondary. Now, here I forgot to save, so let me go back here and save this. And here I forgot to save as well, so let me go back to button primary and save my background color. I want to make sure I'm only saving the background color, because if I save all those other properties, it will kind of override everything I have in my BTN class, and I don't want that. So now let's say I apply the BTN class here. I see that I have the rounded edges, but not the primary color. And if I make a change to my BTN class, let's say now I want text to be huge. Let's save this. The changes are saved across all my buttons because they all have the BTN class. One last thing I want to do is on my button primary, I want to create a hover subclass. I'll create this and choose my hover state. You see here that it's linked to my button primary class. And now if I change the background color to hover primary, I have a different blue on hover. One last little thing to watch out for. Here, we see that we have a hover state. So if we want to edit this, we see that in the default state, we have the button and button primary classes. But if we change to hover state, we have the button class, the button primary class, and the hover subclass linked to the button primary class. So if we wanted to apply the same style to this button, we would have to say, okay, make sure that on the default state, you apply those two classes. And then on the hover state, make sure to also apply the hover subclass of button primary. That's it. That's how you can create and apply reusable styles in WeWeb. How you choose to organize your design system is up to you. You have the option to create multiple classes, and for each class, you can create one subclass.